Today we start with Sam Altman, who is creating nothing less than a global coalition for the development of AI infrastructure. This week, Altman met with investors and officials in the UAE to discuss how the private sector can help countries maintain costly large-scale AI infrastructure. These meetings will focus on maintaining US and allies' leadership in artificial intelligence and ensuring access to the relevant infrastructure. Earlier, Altman highlighted the need for cooperation with the American government to create a multi-billion dollar enterprise for chip production. It was previously reported that Altman plans to build dozens of modern facilities for producing chips for computational accelerators and is trying to attract investor funds from the Middle East for this project. The disclosed information shows that Altman's interactions with officials worldwide are much wider and more diverse. Besides chip manufacturing, Altman also discussed the possibility of using other resources, including energy and data center capacities. Meanwhile, Google has launched Vids, an AI-based application that combines video creation with real-time collaboration. The market is not short of tools for creating videos using artificial intelligence, but the Corporation of Goodness decided to focus on convenience. The user does not need to buy another application and spend time learning how it works. Vids is initially integrated with Google Documents, Slides, and Spreadsheets. Everything is done in the browser, so there is no need to send files by email. Work can be performed in a team using the same access control and security tools provided for the entire workspace. All this is done using Google Gemini. After the work is completed, you need to ask the AI to share the project with colleagues, and Gemini will take care of everything. Thus, customers can create everything in one place, from product presentations to training materials, video clips, and much more. The emergence of Vids does not put Google in line with Adobe and other video editor developers. Vids is not positioned as a replacement for professional tools such as Adobe, Premiere, and Final Cut Pro. The application is more suitable for those who want to quickly and easily edit a video clip without the need to master complex programs. But let's distract from AI while we can and see what else interesting is happening in other industries. Although, let's do one more. Nike has applied a new approach to the process of creating sneakers. The brand used artificial intelligence to design models of the AIR line. The futuristic sneakers were demonstrated at an exhibition in Paris dedicated to the Olympic Games. During the creation of the pairs of shoes, the manufacturer paid attention not only to the design, but also to functionality. For this, famous athletes were asked questions about what footwear is comfortable for them and what is not before the generation process. More than 5 pairs of sneakers were created. All of them are made in a white-orange color scheme. Each pair has a black brand logo, the recognizable swoosh, and the inscription Air. All sneakers look unconventional and are very different from the usual footwear that the brand releases. The shoes were displayed to show how artificial intelligence can be applied in practice when creating wardrobe items. It is possible that someday Nike will indeed launch such shoes for sale. Canadian startup Sanctuary AI, which became popular due to the creation of the humanoid robot Phoenix, has made a deal with parts manufacturer Magna International. And Magna International is a manufacturer of components and parts for the cars of the Volkswagen, Ferrari, and BYD consortiums. The humanoid robots will fully work in factories like people. The robot Phoenix is equipped with dexterous human-like hands. Thanks to this, the robot can be adapted to almost any task, for example, transporting goods or creating parts on machines. In the coming months, Magna International intends to launch the first batch of robots at factories and test the humanoids in action. Meanwhile, a team of engineers from 2 Hong Kong universities has constructed an unusual jumping robot. In the specialists' experiment, 1 quadcopter was involved. A spring-loaded telescopic leg was attached to its lower part, and to make it work properly, researchers also added a couple of stabilizers to the drone. This new ability reduced the drone's battery discharge, allowing it to have a longer flight time. The leg also helped the device lift much heavier loads, as it no longer has to hold them in the air all the time. Tests showed that in addition to pure vertical jumps, the robot is capable of jumping on uneven surfaces and moving horizontally. This means that the leg can be used as a kind of bumper, preventing damage if the robot bumps into a wall or other structure. The quadcopter can be used in disaster zones. There it will help in assessing and searching for survivors. It can also handle work on a farm. Imagine how it jumps from plant to plant, checking the soil and moisture levels. In the meantime, Japan said goodbye to the giant robot Gundam. Gundam, built by Bandai, was the first of its kind moving robot, which used an advanced system of 36 moving elements. This design allowed it to perform simple mechanical actions, such as walking in place, waving its arms, and turning its head. For several years, the 25-ton replica of the robot from the anime delighted Japanese and tourists in Yokohama, but now it has been dismantled. Bandai organized the last exhibition of the robot, where key characters of the franchise were presented. The creator of the universe, Yoshiyuki Tomino, even participated in the event. The event ended with a large-scale fireworks display and a drone flight over Tokyo Bay. Let's move on. The RoboDog Spirit has begun training for rescue missions on the moon. Spirit underwent field tests as part of the LASSIE project, which involved a team of engineers, cognitive scientists, geologists, and planetologists. According to researchers, these tests were part of the process of studying the characteristics of the soil and how to move across similar terrains. The data collected about Spirit's movements will be used to train robots intended for work on the moon, other planets, and even beyond the solar system. The development team claims that the robot can feel the surface, similar to how we sense it when walking over uneven terrain. Spirit perfected its motor skills, starting from the sandy beaches of Southern California to the soil of White Sands National Park in New Mexico. Frames shot on Palmer Glacier on Mount Hood demonstrate surreal and otherworldly landscapes, reminiscent of other planets. These terrestrial tests provide Spirit with opportunities for training and adaptation before it embarks on potential explorations beyond Earth. And with this, we smoothly transitioned to space. After two delays at the Vostochny Cosmodrome, the launch of the Russian Angara A-5 rocket finally took place, marking the beginning of flight design tests of the Amur Space Rocket Complex with heavy-class Angara carriers. It is noted that the Angara A-5 does not use toxic fuel components. Therefore, in the near future, it will replace the currently used Proton-M, which contains toxic components in its fuel. The rocket successfully reached the designated orbit without incidents. And the USA will take a Japanese astronaut to the moon in exchange for a Lunar Rover. Yes, a treaty was signed between the countries under which the Japanese side will develop and transfer the Lunar Cruiser Rover to NASA. It will be delivered to the moon on the eve of the seventh stage of the Artemis mission, approximately in 2031. The rover will be a significant contribution from the Japanese space agency, JAXA, to the Artemis program, said JAXA President Hiroshi Yamakawa. It will enable longer expeditions, as its estimated range of action exceeds that of the lunar terrain vehicle, which is being developed by three private American companies. In the two-seater Japanese rover, astronauts will be able to stay up to 30 days. The overall service life of the apparatus is 10 years. In return, the American Space Agency will provide the Japanese side with two places for astronauts in future manned flights with landing on the moon. One of them will be the first non-US citizen to set foot on the surface of the Earth's satellite. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to stay updated on high-tech news. Peace to your home.